Hi there, my name is Andre, and today we're going to be going over how to update your domain settings to get your custom domain working with Hushmail. I know it can be daunting or confusing to dig into the back end of your domain, but don't worry, we're going to be going through these steps together one at a time. Before we get started, you may want to double check that this is the right video for you. The steps to update domain settings can be very similar for each domain host, but I can be much more helpful to you if this is the video that's specific to your domain host. So let's go ahead and get started. We're here on the Squarespace website. We're going to go up into the top right-hand corner to log in. All right, we're logged in, and this may look different for you. For us, we only have one test domain in here. You may have more than that. What's important is that before we start managing anything, that you make sure that we are working with the correct domain. So to the far right-hand side, I'm going to click on the three dots here to open up the menu, and we're going to go into settings. And then on the far left-hand column here, we're going to click on where it says domains. If I click on that, we see the domain that we're working with. I'm going to click on that. And then we're going to scroll down just a little bit, and we're going to click on where it says DNS settings. Okay, great. So this is everything that we need here. Custom records are going to be down below. Just know that if you have any existing MX records or TXT records that have, you know, anything with mail in it, if you see the words or the letters SPF or any records that have the type MX, you're going to want to delete those so that they don't conflict with what we're going to add in. So I'm going to start with deleting the conflicting records, and Squarespace separates it pretty well here, so we can see likely what anything that you need to touch is going to be within the custom records section down at the bottom here. So I'll click on the little red trash can icons to remove these, and then we'll go through the workflow of adding them in. Okay, perfect. And that's what we want. We want it to say no custom records. There may be something else in here that's unrelated to mail. Like I said, you're looking for the MX type, as well as anything that has the word mail in there. So we're going to click on now where it says add record towards the far right hand side. And we're going to start with the MX records. There's going to be two of them total. And I'm going to start with the at symbol for the host. For type, we're going to select MX. Priority will be the number 10. And then the data will be this. We'll click on save to the right. Nice. We're going to click on add record again. We're going to do the at symbol. This is going to look almost identical to what we just did. plsmtp2.hushmail.com. The only difference is that instead of the number 1 that we did earlier, we're going to do the number 2. So I'm going to click on save here. And we have our two MX records. So I'm going to go in now to add in the SPF record. Let's click on add record here. Again, the host symbol is just going to be the at symbol. Type is going to be TXT. And then for value, we're going to do V equals SPF1 space include colon underscore SPF.hushmail.com space hyphen all. This is going to be something that you can copy from the guide, so you don't have to type it out and potentially miss a space, or if you have any typos in there, it's just not going to work. So ideally, you want to copy and paste that, and you can do that from any of the guides that we have with the SPF record details in there. You can click on save when you're done. And then we're going to add in the last two records. The first one is going to be type is going to be CNAME. And we want for the host, I'm gonna copy and paste this from the guide. But for host, we want hush.underscore domain key, just like that. And then underscore dkim.hushmail.com for the data here, for the alias data. We're gonna click on save. And then the final record that we're gonna add in here is gonna be the DMARC. So again, I'm gonna copy and paste from the guide, DMARC. Type will be TXT, and then the text here will be just this. So it's V equals DMARC 1, semicolon, and then the rest of it. Just click on save when you're done. Make sure you give it a chance, and it'll give you a confirmation that the custom record was saved. And you should have five records that we just added in there now. And if there aren't any typos and you have everything correct, then you're good to go. That's it. You're all set. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. You'll find some useful links below, but we're always here for you if you need us. Thanks again for choosing Hushmail, and have a great rest of your day.